Yarrow me hearties, it's Izzy Noodles and welcome to a brand new walkthrough. Another non-Tomb Raider this time. This is Pirates, The Legend of Black Cat. This game is so childishly fun. I love this game so much, I wanted to share it with you. So, here in the menu, you've obviously got New Game. There's Sea Battle, which I think you can battle in ships with a friend. I don't have friends, so I've never tried. You can load a game from Continue. You've got your options. And here, we've got Scrapbook. Throughout the game, you can find Scrapbook Shells, which can kind of be regarded as secrets. They unlock artwork, which can be viewed here in the Scrapbook. And there's 200 to find. So, now, let's set sail on this adventure.
Lock it!
It's mine. You can't have it.
Ah, forgive an old salty's rough ways, lass. That locket of yours just caught me eye, is all.
It's magic. At least, that's what my mother says.
Well then, ye must have heard of the Wind Dancer.
The Wind Dancer?
Them were the days before bounty hunters lurked in every port. The pirates owned the sea. And the best ship as ever set sail was the one they called the Wind Dancer.
Sink the Crimson Guard gunboats before they sink you. Okie dokie. So yeah, you set off a bit slow. So in the bottom left corner, you've got two gauges filling up there, two big circles. The blue one is for the sails. You can get wind in the sails, but it does have a cooldown. And the yellow one is the cannons, the main cannons. So that's... Oh, I've already sank that other one, just about. Nice. And then your three little circles there are the ship's health.
You're a fool to resist me, Governor. These islands are now mine.
Not while I still breathe, Hawk.
As you wish. You and your accursed family will not stand in my way.
There's a fire in the town. My father's life may be in danger.
The governor?
I'm going ashore. I'll have to make my way to town on foot. Pick me up when the tide comes in.
Aye, Captain.
Father, no!
My dearest Katarina, my wounds are deep and my life is fleeting. There is much to tell you and little time. Your mother, my beloved Mara, was a pirate captain. I never told you for fear that you would follow in her footsteps. You should have your mother's things. She would have wanted that. They are hidden beneath the floor of this room. You must
visit your mother's grave, you'll find it.
My mother was a pirate?
Make way to your ship, the Wind Dancer. And that we shall do. So this is us, this is Katarina, and welcome to Buccaneer Bay. So let me show you the map. Okay, so you can see Katarina on the map and you can see where the ship is. And you can see up and down at the bottom it shows maps, but we've only got this one map so far, so nothing will happen. Left and right shows the menus, it shows our current statistics on the game. So there's Katarina's health and the ship's health, the hull and the sails there, which are two things you need to pay attention to when you are in your ship. Gold doubloons, which is treasure you have collected. Crystal hearts, you can get health increases whenever you find a crystal heart. She can have a total of 9 hearts of health. And the first heart we find is classed as heart 4. But I will be referring to it as Heart 1, as it will be the first heart that we pick up. We get stored upgrades. There's chart stones there, which are to do with unlocking new maps. Chest keys, I will talk more about that in a bit. The type of ship we currently have, which for now is a bus ship. And there's how many cannons we currently have on our ship as well. Also, there are various missions and whatnot. They can be completed, and more will show up here as we progress in fulfilling what's going on kind of thing. Okay, so this will be a 100% walkthrough, but I won't necessarily pick up every treasure like this. So treasures come in different shapes and colours. Most of them can be lying around. There is another one just down here. So this one down here looks like a sack of gold coins. So that's how much they can vary. And they're all worth any kind of amount. Sometimes only sort of 50, sometimes 1,000, sometimes more. So it really varies. Okay, and here we have a treasure chest. So when you're near a chest, you get the option in the top corner to press the action button. So anytime you can press action, you get a prompt in the top corner. So exclusively for PlayStation, L2 is the action button. So in chests you can find more treasure, or you can find important items. Defeat any pirates that get in your way. So basically this gate here will not open until I've defeated these pirates. And they're already laying into me. Rude. Ow. Oh my goodness, what? What do you want? So you can block as well with L1. Okay. So there's another gate up ahead there. So I'm just going to take a left down this passage. There is a chest through here. These monkeys are fun as well. Get the crabs. So any enemies, you may as well actually kill them, because they do drop treasure like 80% of the time. Sometimes they don't, but the vast majority of the time, they will. Okay, let's kick these pirates' asses. So as I attack, you can see the sword gauge in the bottom left corner is filling up. So there's like a three tier level, whatever, sort of stronger attack you can unleash. So level 1 is indicated by a single sword, level 2 has 2 swords. Was there not another guy? Well anyway, And a level 3 stronger attack will show 3 swords in that corner. So once you unleash the attack, it just empties the gauge completely. So be sure that, just so you know, you won't have a bit of gauge left. It all empties. It just depends how strong you want your attack. So I'll show that off.
I know there's treasure nearby.
Maybe in a bit. And she says that she knows there's treasure nearby. So another thing is you can dig up buried treasure. So you get the prompt in the corner. So press action and that digs it up. And then press it again to open the chest. We got some more treasure. Okie dokie. And come on through. And what is this? What's this lying around?
I need the iron key.
So this is an iron chest, which she has stated we need the iron key for. So there are different keys to find for different chests. You must search for the iron key. So you can get a stone key, a crystal key, obviously an iron key, and there's a skeleton key you can also find. So if you interact with a chest, even though you cannot open it, if you have a look at the map now, that chest has been marked on the map, so we know where it is to come back to this location later on. So I didn't point that out. That was actually where Katarina's face was pulsating on the map there. The teleporter ring has been activated. The magic of the teleporter ring has been invoked.
I'm sensing buried treasure nearby.
So there is a chest, another chest. Let me get that. There it is. So I forgot to also mention that finding buried treasure only really helps if you have a vibrating controller. The closer you are to the chest, the stronger the vibration. The further you are away, the weaker the vibration. So that's how you find the buried chests. So with teleporters, they activate when you get to the far end of an island, and it's mostly just a shortcut back to your ship. It takes you back to your ship. But sometimes they can take you somewhere else. So let's see what's going on with this teleporter. Okay, we are somewhere completely different. Where are we? Let's have a look at the map. So anytime you end up in a new location, you automatically get a new map. So you can cycle through like so. We are at the Lonely Tombs. Okay, so what's going on here? What's up with this place? So straight ahead, you can see that there is a chest there. That's the main chest. But I'm going to ignore it for now because there is also a chest on here. And we have found magic sand. Anytime you find a new item that you have not yet picked up, you'll be shown it on the screen like this. So this is mystical sand from the ancient lands. Puts most enemies in range to sleep. Nice. So as we find new items, you see in the bottom right corner there is a compass. And you can cycle through with R1 and R2. We've only got the sand so far, so that's the only thing that's showing up. And across the way,
I smell gold.
She can smell gold. There is another buried chest right here. Scrapbook shell! We have found the first scrapbook shell. So some of them are really easy to find, some of them are very difficult. And there is the rare one that you cannot return to that location. So if you don't get it while you're there, you will not be able to get it. So collect these shells to unlock special artwork within the pirate scrapbook, which is available in the game menu. Nice. So now let's open this main chest, see what we got. Iron key! We have already found it. That's awesome. This key will open all iron treasure chests. Fire tiki. When invoked, this tiki calls forth a rain of fire from the heavens. So this is used as a weapon. This is in the inventory in the bottom right corner. You can find different ones. A couple of examples are ice and thunder. So that's quite awesome. And here, it's actually going to force you to use that. So we've got the teleport to take us back to Buccaneer Bay. And we've got the message at the top. Oh, just want these skeletons all together. So select your fire tiki, and triangle uses the item that's selected in the corner. So it kind of forces you to use it there. I suppose it's so you understand what it does. But using it activates the teleport and we can go back. But first, let's just have another quick look at the map. In the top right corner, it shows we have opened 3 out of 3 chests and we have found 1 of 1 scrapbook shell. So this map is complete. Awesome. Let's get out of here. Okay, we are back at Buccaneer Bay. So let's go and open up that iron chest now that we've found the key. So these crabs have respawned. A lot of enemies respawn very often. So that's something to be aware of. If you think the coast is clear, no, they respawn. And when you re-kill an enemy, you don't always get treasure. Okay, so I did get treasure. Not a lot, but they still drop treasure, so that's good. So open up the iron chest. So every time I find a new item, I will do my best to use it straight away. So I'll use the magic sand on these enemies. Some items I just won't use. For example, the magic sand. I don't always use that. There are just other things I can use. So just use it. Oh, ow. That was rude. Use it on these two guys. They've fallen asleep. If you attack them, they will wake up. You can get grog lying around that puts your health up. And now I'm gonna show off the stronger attack there. One hit did the trick, so that was a bit OP. So that was the level 3 stronger attack. Square will do that attack. Another chest, which contains another scrapbook shell. Well done, your ship and crew await you to set sail. However, you should save your game at the save game parrot first. So you don't have to save your game, it's just letting you know that you can save your game at the parrots, which is awesome. Parrots! I'm also not going to set sail yet either. I'm going to finish exploring this section of the island. Liberate your father's fortress. Liberate your father's town fortress from the Crimson Guard. So if we have another look at the map, the fortress is the red square there on the left. So not every map has a fortress, but most of them do, and I do recommend liberating fortresses. Just, you know, attack them till they surrender. There you can buy things for your ship, such as, you know, weaponry to use. You can upgrade your ship, so that's cool. And you also get monies for taking over the fortress. Also, you've already noticed there are question marks dotted around. These are docks that we have not yet visited. Once you've visited one, the question mark will go away. I assume there's a question mark right at this one because I have not yet set sail from here. I don't know. Plot hole. But anyway, let's continue exploring this section. Kill the crabs. They do make a satisfying sound. Okay. So there is another gate just around this corner. Gate is the word I said. It kind of came out a bit funny there. I'm just going to go up this grassy hill. There's a chest and a scrapbook shell. You might need to jump. Here we go, because it's a bit slopey at the top. Okay, and now through the gate. I'll probably show off the level 1 attack here as well. I use it on an actual pirate, not a crab. So So, iron chest. Open that up. Get scraps. Well, I'll do it now, because otherwise the gauge will fill up. But yeah, handy stuff. And we have a new chest here. What is this?
I need the stone key.
We need the stone key. So this is I was going to say iron. No, it's a stone chest. Okay, pick up all the treasures, kill all the pirates. Nice. Okay, so this teleport just here isn't very obvious. I think it activates once you open that last chest. I could be wrong. But even though we're not that far away from the ship, this will take us back to the ship. Nice. So from here, I will set sail. We'll explore the other docks on this map. And we do have a couple of ships. Find the map to Ape Island. So this is our main objective right now. You do get loot crates there in the sea. Once you've blown up a ship, that's when they drop the crates. So the loot crates can contain treasure or things to repair your ship. Or weapons, like cannons to use from your ship. This ship is so annoying. Fire! And you can ram the ships as well. Do take off your health though, your ship's health. It does damage to your ship, is what I'm trying to say. So here's the fortress. I will deal with these ships first. There is also a turret on this little island. So that's firing at you as well. Come on. There we go. I'm a bit stuck here now though. Hurry up and blow up, I'm stuck. So that ship has blown up and dropped loot crates. Oh my goodness, my cannons are missing. There we go. So this little ship is really easy to blow up. Just gonna get that turret that's on the island there. Keep shooting. There we go. Pick up these loot crates. So sometimes when you can't pick them up, that means you are full of whatever item that happens to be in there. So in the loot crates, I have picked up sailcloth and lumber. So these repair the ships. So these are the two things you need to pay attention to. And you heard sounds of sawing as I picked some of them up. That means that I was full of an item, so it automatically just went and repaired my ship for me. So now let's liberate the fortress. So this one's really easy. You can just hover in front of it, and I do not recommend that as you progress in the game, because the fortresses can hold a lot of cannons that do a lot of damage. This one's not so bad. But once you've destroyed it, they show a white flag. There we go, and that means you can dock. So dock with the surrendered town fortress to take it over. Here you will receive your reward. Yes. And be able to make repairs and buy cargo. Nice. So I actually won't do that just yet. I want to save up some more pennies. So I'm going to dock here. This little island. There's only really chests in this little section. So just kill the crabs. Get your pennies. Okay, there is a buried chest in this tuft of grass. There it is. Which contains a scrapbook shell. There's an iron chest. Did I open that? No. Another scrapbook shell. Okay. And there is a stone chest.
I need the stone key.
So even though we can't open it, don't forget to interact with it anyway, and it will be marked onto your map. Alrighty, that's this little section done, so let's get back to the ship. Go to another dock we've not yet been to. Alrighty, you can easily maneuver your ship. That's quite handy. Can I pick this up yet? Nope. So let's go to this dock. Okay, so here you can go to the right, but there's a closed gate that will only open from the opposite side, so there's no point. You need to actually go up the hill. There is a buried chest right in the corner though, so I'll get that before I go up the hill. Just grab the treasure somewhere among these trees.
I know there's treasure nearby.
So do I. Oh, there it is. Nice. Okay, kill crabs. There's another one. There you are. Okay. Follow the path. Slide on down. And there's the gate that is closed from the other side. It only opens from this side. Throwing knives. Well-balanced knives made for throwing. So these are quite handy. So let's select them and toss them at these pirates. Ow. Okay, grab the treasure. There is a buried chest.
Buried treasure nearby.
Yep, so if you did explore the opposite side of this gate, you will be wandering around for ages trying to find the chest, because she says she can sense the treasure when you're on the opposite side of the gate. So it's this side. Island chart. A cartographer's chart of an island chain opens up a new place on the world map to explore. You have found a chart leading to mysterious 8 islands. Set sail for the open seas and then activate the world map. So I won't be doing any of that new map this time round. I will save that for the next video. But you can only view the world map once you set sail for the open sea. So once you're in your ship, just sail away from the island and you will get the action trigger in the top left corner to open up the world map and select a new place to go to. But none of that this time around, sorry. 8th island will be for next time. So in the grass, there is a stone chest. Mark it on the map.
I need the stone key.
Beware of the crabs that come out of the grass as well. They sneak up on you. And there is a buried chest near
I
the sea.
Smell gold.
There it is. Okay, so now I'm gonna go back to the fortress. Dock at the fortress and see what they got. Ooh. Okie dokie, so you can only buy things for your ship at the fortress, and this is actually the only place you can buy things for your ship. So we can buy a chain shot, a length of spiked chain welded to a cannonball used to shred the sails of your enemies. So these are specifically to damage sails, so those are handy. Stink bombs causes the crew of the enemy ship to choke and gag, making cannon aiming impossible for a short duration. Fire pots! These are handy, I use them a lot. Ceramic pots filled with a highly flammable and sticky substance causes fires to ignite on deck and in sails. And we can get a ship upgrade already, so this is why I wanted to make sure I had enough pennies. So cannons, we have 2 of 2 for our little bus ship. and this is where we can buy lumber and sailcloth as well to repair the ship. Or you can also make full repairs, so put your ship's health back to 100%. But you always best to have a look to see if you can upgrade your ship before you repair your ship, because otherwise you've just wasted your money on your repairs if you're just going to buy a ship anyway. So I will go for the ship upgrade. So let's just, take a look at our little bus before we trade it in. It's kind of a bit battered there. But let's upgrade the ship to a sloop. Okie dokie. So we have the sloop. I'll show that off once I get out of the menu here. I'm going to buy just a few of these. We can now carry more than what we could on the bus ship. I'm not going to buy a lot of anything, because you can just find them lying around, especially once you've taken down ships. They drop their loot crates. A few of them. A few of these. A few more of these. Yeah, there we go. And we can add cannons. So the bigger the ship, the more cannons you can have. I won't bother buying any lumber or sailcloth. Yep, I will leave it as that. So this is our new sloop ship. Nice. Okay, so let's have a look at the map, see where we've not been. Got two more docks on the opposite side of the island, so let's go and check them out. So once you've lost the wind from your sails, it's actually a very slow journey. Yeah.
Full sails!
Just plodding along in my ship. Come on. Okay, so the only things that are actually at this dock are scrapbook shells. So there's one over in the corner here. And the crabs on this island I actually will just ignore, because they don't drop any treasure whatsoever. Don't know why, but they just don't. The outrage. But come up the hill just here. And there's a scrapbook shell just hovering. There it is. More guys. I keep forgetting to show off this, so I'm trying to do this a lot. There we go, check that out. Okay, and in this chest is another scrapbook shell. And that's it, so back to the ship. Okay, and then round to the last dock that we have not yet been to. Alrighty. So there's nothing to the left, there is a safe parrot there. So I'm going to come to the right hand side, but firstly let's look at the map. You may have already spotted that there's that face on the map there. Guy wearing a top hat. So, who's that? We will find out, but first, there is a chest over here. So, what's this? This is new? New kind of chest?
I need the crystal key.
So, this is a crystal chest, which we need the crystal key for.
I smell gold!
And there is a buried treasure as well. So let me show you the captain's log. So we've kind of found out that we do need other keys. So anytime you discover a new quest or whatever, that always comes up here. So those are in no particular order of completion. It's just when you find out about stuff, it comes up in the log, but you don't really need to look at that. Yes, so there it is. Another scrapbook shell. And now let's come through here. This is where the guy is. You can see his hut. Who are you? What do you want?
Ah, welcome, welcome, my fine young lad. And what can I do for you today?
Who are you?
Why, I am a procurer of wondrous merchandise from near and distant lands.
You're a smuggler.
And you're a pirate. We all have our problems.
Ah, yes, I see your point. And what do you have to sell?
Why don't you take a look?
Okay, so this guy is a smuggler, and his face will always be on the map, even if you've only just arrived at the new map. So that's very helpful, it lets you know where he will be. Also, any safe pirates will be on the map already as well, so that's even more helpful. So, he's not got a lot to sell so far, we've not really found much. We found the throwing knives, so he's offered to sell us those. And grog. So the thing with health is the grog puts up your health, but you do not carry anything with you to put your health up. Some of the enemies will drop heart, so you increase a heart of your health if it's low. And you do get the grog lying around, so that also puts your health up a bit. But these are the only ways you can put your health up. So you can also pay him to have a sip of his mystic potion brewed by pirates for use on the high seas. Heals Katarina to full health, used instantly and not carried by Katarina. So I won't bother having any of that because my health's not too bad. So that's all he's got so far in the game. So I'm sorry, dude. Nothing from you today. Because the throwing knives, even though I don't have many, there is another scrapbook shell there. Even though I don't have many throwing knives at the moment, they can easily be found lying around. A lot of things can just be found lying around, so don't always buy, don't fill up your stocks completely. So as you can see, I'm coming up to this slope. You need to come to the point to come up here because it's a bit too slopey to come up the side. Got more guys. Got some grog that he dropped there.
Grog!
Ow. Okay. Got a chest full of treasure. And another scrapbook shell. So now you can slide down here. And you've got some mystic sand that's just lying around. So let me show you. I have two in my inventory so far. If I pick this up, I've picked up five. But now it just says I have five in the inventory. So a lot of things you can only carry five of. The throwing knives are an exception. And there are a few things that are an exception to that. But most things you can only carry five of. So, this is actually where I'm going to call the video for today. Hope you've enjoyed it. It's been a bit kind of childish and fun, but there's nothing wrong with that. So, thought there was another crab there. There will be some backtracking to do in the game, but I won't be doing any of that until the very end. So, if you're playing along and want to get everything, let's just do a recap of what we should have found. We should have 22 chests and 11 scrapbook shells. So, even though the map here of Buccaneer Bay says 19 of 23 chests, so you can see the four that I cannot open already marked on the map there. Don't forget, we have also visited the Lonely Tombs, so we've got a few more chests that we've opened there. So, that's it for today. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time. We'll be setting sail for Ape Island. Take it easy, guys.